Hello dear students, welcome back. I know you must have gone through the first two sessions, and as per the instruction you people have read the textbook and written down the dictations as per the advice. Now in session 3 we will do question answers. So let us start with the chapter 3 in the earlier cities, session 3 of question and answer. So the first question is, how do archaeologists know that cloth was used in the Harappan civilization? The answer is, according to archaeologists, cotton was probably grown in Mehrgarh about 7000 years ago. Actual pieces of cloth were found attached to the lid of a silver vase and some copper objects of Mohenjo-daro. Archaeologists have also found spindle roll made of terracotta and faience. These were used to spin thread. We also have indirect evidence to show how cloth was decorated. For example, a stone statue of an important man found at Mohenjo-daro shows him wearing an embroidered garment. Second question is, match the column. In column A is question and the answer is in column B. So first is copper. It was found in Rajasthan. Second is gold, found in Karnataka. Third is tin, found in Afghanistan. Fourth is precious stone, found in Gujarat. So question 3, why were metals, writing, the wheel and the plow important for the Harappans? The answer is metal. The Harappan made copper tools. They also made ornaments of gold and silver. Writing was very important for Harappans. There were scribes, people who knew how to write. Scribes helped prepare the seals and perhaps wrote on those materials that have not survived. Wheel. The Harappans used the wheel in carts. They also used the wheel in spinning. The wheel was used by potters to make or shape pots and other things. Plough was used to prepare the land for farming by the Harappans. Question 4. Make a list of all the terracotta toys shown in the lesson. Which do you think children would have enjoyed playing with the most? Answer. The terracotta toys shown in the lesson are toy cart. I've given the image. A toy plow. I've given the image. From these two, what the children must have enjoyed the most? That is toy cart. So images are given. Children would have preferred toy carts instead of plow. Students, you don't need to have the pictures. The pictures are given for your referral so that you understand what I actually mean by toy cart or a toy plow. Okay, so just write down the answer, no need of the image. Fifth is, make a list of what the Harappans ate and put a tick mark against the things you eat today. The answer is, food items eaten by Harappans: wheat, barley, pulses, peas, rice, sesame, lean seed, mustard, fruits. Select the things you eat today. For me, I eat all these things today. So things that were eaten during the Harappan period are still available in my period. I eat all these things. So do you? If you eat all, tick all. If you eat some of these, tick some of these. Question 3. Do you think that the life of farmers and herders who supplied food to the Harappan cities was different from that of the farmers and herders you read about in chapter 3? Reasons for your answer. Yes. I think that the life of farmers and herders who supplied food to the Harappan cities was different from that of the farmers and herders I read about in last lesson. I can give the following reasons for my answer. We know from remains of plants and bones of animals that the contemporary farmers and herders of the Harappans grew more cereals and collected many types of fruits and other things. They grew wheat, barley, pulses, peas, rice, sesame, lean seed and mustard. Second is, a new tool, the plow, was used to dig the earth for turning the soil and sowing seeds by the farmers of the Harappan times, while real plows, which were probably made of wood, have not survived. Toy molds have been found. As the Harappans region did not receive heavy rainfall, some form of irrigation might have been used. This means that water was stored and supplied to the fields when the plants were growing. The Harappans reared cattle, sheep, goat and buffalo. Water and pasture were available around settlements. However, in the dry summer months, large herds of animals were probably taken to greater distance in search of water and grass by the farmers and herders mentioned in the last lesson. But the Harappan age people also collected fruits like caught fish and hunted wild animals like the antelope. The farmers and herders of the Indus Valley had relations with better or more civilized people who had better houses, roads, drain system, knowledge of writing, and cities. The farmers and herders of the last chapter or the Stone Age did not know the use of metals. So, with the sixth question, we finish the question and answer session. I instruct you again to write down these question answers in your notebook for your recitation and your referral. Student, it's a humble request for you to write down the question answers in your notebook. This will help you during the exams to recite the question and answers and write them and pass with good marks. In the last exam, what we had, while checking the question and answer sheets, I have found that students have not read the question answers and writing question answers from Google or from the textbook, which are not relevant to the questions. When we are giving you ready-made question answers, why don't you recite them and write them? It is good to find questions from the textbook, at least you are trying. But when you are trying, you should know what exact answer is required for the question and answer. Okay? So you can continue finding answers from the textbook, but recite these question answers and take referral from the textbook. Do not find any question answer from Google. We come to know as we teachers, we know how our students can write their answers. Okay, so please, I'm saying again, write question answers in your notebook so that you can recite during the exams and pass with flying colors. If you write answer which does not match with the question or which is not related to the question, you lose your marks. Though you are good in studies, but the question and the answer, if they do not match and the answer is wrong, you will lose your marks and your marks will come down. So do you want that to happen in next exams? If no, please write down the question and answers in your notebook and recite. Thank you. Have a great day.